I will show the management of a luxated IOL. First, we perform a limbal barotomy at 3 o'clock and 9 o'clock. Then we insert the trocars and a chandelier light. Here you see the luxated IOL with capsular bag and capsular tension ring, which lies on the posterior pole. Then we inject PFCL and remove bimanually the capsular bag with the vitreous cutter whilst holding the IOL with a serrated jaw forceps. Next, we place two sclerotomies 1.5 mm behind the limbus at 3 o'clock and 9 o'clock using the 20 gauge sclerotomy knife. Next, we remove the capsular tension ring with the serrated jaw forceps from the interior chamber. Next, we go through the 3 o'clock serotomy, grab the end of the haptic, flick the biome out, and draw the haptic out of the 3 o'clock sclerotomy. Then we take a Proline 10-0 suture with two bend needles, cut it in two halves from Alcon, and suture one half to the haptic. A quite tedious procedure. Then we push the haptic back into the vitreous cavity using again the serrated jaw forceps. On the top right you see the chandelier light from Synergetics, which sits very nicely in the sclera. The same procedure at 9 o'clock, insert the forceps at 9 o'clock, grab the haptic, draw it out, fixate the suture and push the haptic back into the eye. Like this, then centrate the IOL by pulling on both sutures carefully. Next, we will fixate the Proline 10-0 suture to the sclera by suturing 5 U-turns or serpentines into the sclera without making a knot at the end, therefore reducing post-operative discomfort. Here you see the 5 U-turns which we suture into the sclera. The same at the other side. Then we remove the PFCL bubble. And this is the end of the operation.